Hello, this is Alex with a short Lightroom video. It's been quite a while since I recorded one of these. Today I want to look at a feature that helps a lot with blending different exposures together. It's called Match Total Exposures and it's only available in Lightroom Classic, not in Camera Raw or Bridge, and not in the Lightroom Cloud version, only Lightroom Classic. In this example, I have only two exposures that I want to blend together, a 6 second bright exposure and a 3 second shorter exposure, dark exposure, to preserve the sky here in my sunset scene. You can see that this is a fairly high contrast image. I bring this up here and you see we have deep dark shadows and we have really bright lights, and in this exposure here, in my 6 second exposure, you can see that the sky is overexposed. So I went ahead and made another exposure, 3 seconds, one stop shorter, where the sky is preserved. I can test this here by dragging my exposure slider all the way down. You see here, no blown out parts in the sky. And here in this exposure, pure white that just turns a dark gray. So all information here is lost to overexposure. And I want to bring these two images together. Here's how I do this. I select them both to begin with, Control or Command A, and I switch to my Develop module. And you see down here in the film strip, both are still selected. And in the Develop module, I have the Auto Sync feature turned on. This means that any edit that I make on the most highlighted image here will be synchronized to the other image that I have also selected here. And that way I have always the same edits on both pictures, and the only thing that I need to adjust afterwards is the overall exposure, which can be done with this Match Total Exposures feature. So to start with, because this is a very high contrast scene and I want to recover a lot of shadows and highlights from it, I switch from the default Adobe color profile to the camera neutral profile, which is a much flatter rendition and also renders the colors of my Nikon camera better. Adobe neutral is even flatter, but the color rendition doesn't match my camera so nicely, so I prefer to use camera neutral for this. But you see that here from Adobe color to Adobe neutral, a lot less highlights are actually showing as blown out. So this makes it a lot easier to work with high contrast scenes to begin with. Again, I use camera neutral because I prefer this color rendition. Very first step, even after almost 20 years of photography, I still can't get the horizon straight, so I straighten that here with my crop tool. And then I make some adjustments to the overall image here. And first I want to get those shadows lifted a little bit out here. The entire exposure can be brighter because that will make my shadow slider respond nicer. And everything's a little bit on the cool side, so maybe I warm all this up a little bit here. And I want to treat this sky here as if it wasn't overexposed, just to get it into the right range so it corresponds nicely with this area here perhaps. And for that, I use a mask, linear gradient, and maybe I begin with some half stop down and the highlights down somewhat, and just place that linear gradient here, feather it out a little bit. I prefer to use the linear gradient for this because of this feathering effect. It's not such a sharp and precise selection as with select sky in the masking feature. And this looks good. Maybe it's a little bit too much already here. So bring the exposure back and just the highlights down a little bit more. I think here is a good point for that for now. What I do notice now is perhaps the bottom part here is a little bit cooler than the top part, because here's still direct sunlight, here everything's in the shade. So maybe I want to bring the sky just down in temperature a little bit so that these blue tones match nicely here and there's less of a discrepancy. Maybe this can have a little bit more magenta tint too. There you go, that looks good. And now maybe I even want to make that still a little bit warmer to give that nice after sunset glow color effect. And with these adjustments in place, I can now look at my second exposure to verify here indeed I have the sky nicely exposed, but the brightness is of course incorrect now because this is an exposure that's one stop darker. Now in this example, this would be very, very easy to actually adjust 6 seconds versus 3 seconds, one stop. I could just type in plus 1.5 here instead of just 0.5 for this to match this. But Lightroom has this feature, match total exposures. So my first one, my second one. And in the settings menu is this option, match total exposures. And you see this does exactly what I just described. It adds this one stop here to the second exposure. So imagine you have 3 exposures that you need to blend, or even more, how much easier this feature will make it to blend these together. Obviously now that I see this updated sky, it's still a little bit on the hot side here. So maybe I go back to my linear gradient filter here, and I simply bring down these highlights a little bit more to make sure that I have a good highlight rendition here in this sky for my blending. I'll bring it down all the way. It doesn't make that much of a difference actually. So we can make it softer with less contrast. That probably helps. And maybe we reduce the clarity a little bit, which also makes the highlights a little bit softer. Okay, good enough for the sake of demonstration. You see here, when I switch back and forth, how very nicely these two images now match brightness-wise, and how easy it will be to just get that sky into the other exposure. Since both are still selected, right-click, add it in, open as layers in Photoshop. Takes a short moment before they are loaded here. There we are. Extremely simple blend. I add a layer mask and then I choose the gradient tool and simply place that gradient here over the sky. And my blending job is done. Couldn't have been easier. Of course, this is an easy example, but you can see the potential, how much easier it will make the blending if you simply have the exposures matched in your pictures. Finalizing steps obviously are missing in this image, but that's not the point of this short video. I'm gonna quit here. Thank you for watching. Bye.